In today's video, I'm going to show you how to change your permalink without creating a 404 error page. Now, I'm sure you've seen this error page before, and it usually comes from broken URL links. And usually what happens is people change their permalink and they end up breaking the URL, and now the page is not there anymore. So I want to show you how you can change your permalink without creating one of those pages. So if you are inside of WordPress right now, what you want to do is go over to a blog post. You can go to anyone that you have, and I'm just going to show you how this is done. Now I'm currently working on one right now that's not published, but I'm going to show you how it's done. All right, so here I am inside of Affiliate Marketing for Beginners. Now at the top of the page, pretty much underneath the title, you will see right here where it says permalink. And permalink is really just the URL address for that blog. So the permalink for this, of course, is Mailbox Money Blog, and it's whatever you name or title the blog post. So this blog post is titled Affiliate Marketing Programs for Beginners. And as you can see right here, it's kind of emboldened. You can see it. So I'm going to click edit, and this will show you how it looks. And you can adjust this and change this as long as the blog post is not published. That's the easy part. So look over here to the right hand side, and you will see under publish, you're going to see some information. Now, one of the things that I typically do is when I first create a blog post, I push the publish date out. I don't want to publish it anytime soon because I'm working on it and I have no idea when I'm going to finish it. So I'll push it out like way far out, months in advance. So this says December. Now, I know I'm going to finish it before then, but that's just the date that I push it out, so it does not accidentally publish if I forget all about it. So you will see over here a date that's pushed far, far out. One of the things that I will do is after I push this date far out, by hitting edit and editing the date, which you can do easily like this, you can edit it. What I usually do is I'll go up here to the top where it says visibility, and I place it on private, and I keep it on private. So as you can see right now, it's on private. I'll just hit OK. And once you update this, because obviously you need to update it, when you click update, then the blog post is going to say privately published. And it's not even published yet because this date right here is like 6 months out. So this is the way that you want to be able to keep it. Now, you can change your permalink however you want or however many times you want. So we can click edit right here and you can change it to whatever. So if I decided that I want to erase this and change it to best affiliate marketing programs for beginners, then I can do that. Click OK. And now the permalink itself is changed and the title still remains the same, of course. So you can see right here, best affiliate, and then it's going to say marketing programs for beginners. This is how you can change your permalink without affecting the URL. Now, before I do anything, I want to check this link right here. So I'm going to update the page. And once I update the page, it's already updated. Then I want to view the post. So you can either click on this link, the permalink itself, or you could just view post. So here we are inside of the post. It's the same one, Affiliate Marketing Programs for Beginners. And you can see up here at the top where it says Best Affiliate Marketing Programs for Beginner. So now that we can go out of here, you see that you can easily make a change to your permalink. It's just that simple. There's nothing to it. You want to make sure that you do that before you publish, because if you publish this blog post and you go back and you try to edit the permalink, that's when you're going to have a ton of problems. You're going to end up with a 404 error page and a broken link, and your blog post is not going to be there. And of course, there's ways of getting it. You're going to have to do so much work. And if you're a beginner, you really don't have time for that. So that's how you change your permalink for your blog post without changing or without creating a 404 error page. All right, guys, so that is it. That's how that's done. And if you like this video, make sure that you check out my other video, how to create categories inside of WordPress. Guys, I am constantly creating videos, of course, here on YouTube, for WordPress, just for building my business online, because I do use my blog to do so. And I have a ton of business tools that I use as well. So make sure that you come back and tune into my channel. And also let me know down in the comment section below if you have ever ended up with a 404 error page. Just let me know down in the comment section and how you removed it. All right, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next video.